What's up, everybody? Once again, it's BrandMan, Sean, and we got to talk about touring strategies for artists who are early on just building their fan base. Now, a lot of times you hear artists trying to figure out, how do I get on somebody else's tour? But this is really about how you can hack your own tour. Now, I first discovered this strategy when somebody I know a few years ago told me that they were going on tour, and I was like, how are you taking your artist on tour when he isn't that huge? Because this was like a 10 city official tour. They did have fans, they've been working for a minute, but a full tour, 10 cities, how? And here it is. First of all, I know a lot of you understand that if you have music playing online and you built a sense of a fan base, you can look at your followers and see what cities they're in and say, hey, I want to target my tour by that city. I could run ads into that city and maybe try to do a show over there. But even with that being said, the cost of touring is so high, it's pretty ridiculous to just say, hey, I'm an artist that really only has like $500 in budget a month and tried to schedule a 10 city tour. Now, what they did was, instead of having their own complete venues, instead of trying to get on tour with somebody else, they actually found multiple underground events in the cities that they knew that not only they had fans, but even some cities where they didn't have any fan base, but just wanted to make entry into, and then start to work their way up from there. So what I mean is, they found underground shows that were already doing promo, already had a small sense of following, and they simply asked, could they be a part of those shows? Some cases, those shows were happy to just have somebody else from a different city. They could use that for promo themselves. Somebody who already had a small sense of a fan base, they could use that for themselves because you're bringing people into the door. And in some cases, those people might have charged a little bit, but it wasn't really that much because these are underground shows. It's not like they were trying to have you come on as an opener for a big artist and they were really giving you a huge look or anything necessarily either, at least not from that standpoint. But at the same time, you're getting the value as an artist by not having to pay the overhead, or as a manager, right? Because when you don't have to pay the overhead and be in charge of all the marketing, when this is just a new market for you and you're getting into it for the first time, you're just getting your feet wet. And I know some people are like, yeah, but how do I even market this? And how do I even really get value out of a tour that isn't mine, or if these aren't big artists? These guys are super independent. So what they did was, hey, I'm on this guy's show that runs every Thursday in this city, and then we're going to this next city. This event may only happen one time a year, but the timing happens to be perfect. And they all have their own individual flyers. But what they did was create also their own tour flyer with every single city on it. And it just looked almost as if that's just their tour, right? They have a tour, they're going to be in those cities. They don't even necessarily talk heavily about the events themselves. So from your fan standpoint, and from all intents and purposes on the front end, it pretty much looks like you got your own tour going on. And what's value about this is, once again, you're going to get in front of some of your fans, you're going to get in front of quite a few new people, and you do not have to pay the overhead. You got somebody marketing to help you out, and you can get in front of a new market, because maybe you come back next year or a few months later and you just do your own show once you realize, hey, okay, my fans actually came out on this show, or hey, this city's worth building relationships in, so let me continue to build with some of the club owners or some of the venues and see what else I can do. It's a great way to just infiltrate a new city and build some relationships. So to summarize what you do in this plan, once again, is, hey, first you research some of these cities around you. In their case, they started around the region. They looked at states around their current state. So they were in Georgia, they looked at Tennessee, South Carolina, Florida, Alabama. They did a lot of research in the well-known cities, and they went on Instagram and other websites, or hit up homies in those cities to find out what are the events going on around a certain time. And after collecting information from all the cities and about all the events, they hacked together, all right, what would the tour schedule look like? How fast would it take us to get from one city to the next? What dates can we make available when we're free? Because they were still working full-time jobs at the time. And then they set it up from there. They had a full-blown tour, basically with a super low overhead. Didn't have to pay for venue, didn't have to pay for marketing, only had to pay for them and themselves. So it was a manager and his artist driving in the car, gas money, and, you know, some McDonald's. And that was all they had to pay for their full tour. Well, some hotel nights as well. But Once again, as always, I want to know what you guys think about this strategy. Have you guys ever done anything like this? Will you use or try it? I suggest a few more people try it because it's a strategy that will work. I've seen it work, and I know a lot of people don't have the money at the time to invest in a full-blown tour or just, you know, maybe even the fan base necessary to, you know, create a real tour and pay all that money. As always, if you like this, hit that like button. If you like it, might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.